Does the back of your keyboard stand look like this? Does your worship keys rig teeter on the brink between chaos and total chaos? Or maybe you've got a USB hub plugged into another USB hub, plugged into a cable extender, plugged into a dongle. If any of these situations is you, then today's video is for you. We're gonna be setting up the world's cleanest keyboard rig. So as we were preparing this video, we posted a question in our private Facebook group. I asked people to share their cleanest rig pictures and for some brave souls to share their less than ideal or their messy looking keys rigs as well. So let's talk about a couple of these pictures. Okay, so the first one here I would say is an example of a nice clean keys rig. They've got a hardware software combo running main stage, Sunday keys. I really like this rig. It looks like they're using a single column support stand. Those are some of my favorites. We'll talk about that a little bit later on in the video. Because they have built-in cable management and because there's just one vertical bar that's supporting the whole keys rig, which minimizes the amount of visual space that the rig takes up. He's also got a small rack here holding the audio interface. Looks like maybe a little bit of a cable shelf there. And then the laptop is sitting on top. I like this look. They've got an iPad stand just to the right for sheet music. I think this is pretty cool. In my opinion, maybe taking up a little bit of vertical space, but I see they've got the keys rig angled to the side a little bit, which means that they're not gonna be completely blocked off from the congregation. So I think that's a really cool picture, a nice clean rig. This next one was submitted and commented when the picture was posted. I need help with cable management. The main thing here that I see is just cables just dropping down from wherever they're plugged into on one end and just sort of dangling to wherever they're going. So you have, I count maybe 6 or 7 different cable lines that are draped down, hanging down from the rig. Now, this is not just an aesthetic issue, but there's also a little bit of a reliability problem here because you're putting weight on all of those connections when the cable is hanging and you're just asking for somebody walking by to accidentally snag their foot or their hand or a microphone or something on one of those cables. I mean, then the least bad thing that could happen then is that something gets unplugged. The worst case scenario is that they actually take your laptop or your keyboard off the stand with them. So we'll talk about some best practices for this in just a couple of minutes. This one actually is kind of cool because they're using a Mac Mini and they've got a little monitor off to the side. And I actually really love tucking the computer away a little bit if you can get comfortable not having it directly in front of you. I really love that, but it looks like there are a few other things going on. We've got some cables hanging from side to side. And it also looks like there might just be a little bit of a space issue where they're sort of sharing this little stand with what looks like maybe a speaker stand. They've got some lighting right around. So it is tough when you have a small amount of space to work in to get things set up really cleanly. But there are some things that you can do to sort of minimize the visual impact that your keys rig has on stage and also minimize points of failure at the same time. This picture was submitted, no, I'm just kidding. This picture is actually mine from a gig that I had the opportunity to play a few years ago. I had just bought a new computer. It was my first computer with USB-C ports. So I had purchased a USB-C dongle, audio interface, nano control, and MIDI controller, all directly connected to this dongle. Thankfully, I made it through this set, but at that day, I committed to do my best to never rely on a dongle hanging off the side of my computer again. So that's my embarrassing rig picture. All right, so let's start to get into some of the specifics of setting up a clean keys rig. And we're gonna give you 3 areas to focus on today. The first is just general cleanliness and cable management. Cable management is the main area that I see most keys rigs having room for improvement. And the great thing is that cable management doesn't have to be super complicated. You have to be willing to make incremental changes or improvements to the way that you run your cables, maybe buy a couple of new cables to make sure you have the length that you need. And with those simple changes, you can make a big improvement to the way that your keys rig looks on stage. So one of the very first things I recommend doing is buying a silver Sharpie or some color of Sharpie that will actually show up on the cables you're using and just write on both ends of the cable something that will indicate what they are. Then if something gets unplugged, you can really quickly trace back what it is. I try to buy cables that are just about the right length that I need. And I'm a big fan of the brand on Amazon called Cable Matters. These are really inexpensive cables, every type of USB connection that you could need, and they sell tons of different lengths, and they are all color-coded. So any cable here with an orange band is a 6-foot cable. Any cable with a red band is a 9-foot cable. They sell 3-foot, 12-foot, 15-foot lengths. Oftentimes I find that people that have sort of those cables hanging all around are doing so because they either have way more cable than they need, so the cable just drapes down to the ground, coils around, and then comes back up to wherever it's plugged in, or there's not enough cable. So in order for the cable to reach from point A to point B, it has to pretty much be a straight line. That's not good because then there's a lot of tension on that cable. If it gets caught, it's gonna get unplugged. And with lots of extra cable, it's much more likely that somebody is gonna trip and yank that cable out of where it's plugged into. So I'll put a link in the description to Cable Matters brand cables. Now there's tons of other great cable manufacturers out there. I just love these, they're on Amazon Prime. The next thing you need to figure out is how permanently are you going to be rigging up your keys rig. If it's something that's gonna be portable, then you need a solution that you can do and undo every single time you set up your keys rig. If your rig is gonna be set up somewhere for a long time, you could look at a keyboard with built-in cable management. I've even seen some people use a step bit to actually drill into the columns of their keyboard stand and run the wires inside. That can be really cool until a cable breaks, or until you need to diagnose a problem quickly, or swap out a keyboard for a different one with a different connection. So if your rig is really permanent, those options can be really cool. There's also these little 3M tape sort of cable routes, like little cable hooks that you can run on the back of your keyboard stand. So in terms of less permanent, more flexible cable management options, I think you have two main ways to consider. First is good old gaff tape, and the second is old reliable cable wraps. If you are going to use gaff tape, I do recommend spending a little bit more money to buy really high quality gaffer tape, because what you don't want is cheaper gaff tape that ends up leaving a bunch of sticky residue on your cables. I'm not quite as big of a fan of using gaff tape, because when you take the tape off, you need to go get fresh tape to wire things back up. And oftentimes, even with the highest quality tape, if it's on there long enough, it is going to leave a little bit of residue. I do think it has its place, especially when you reach the floor and you need to permanently tape stuff down so it doesn't get tripped over. Gaff tape is excellent for that. But for the majority of cable management, I really love just using simple cable wraps like this. So next, let's talk about visual cues during your live performances. If you're gonna be able to manipulate your worship cue sounds during a service, you need to be able to understand visually what you're looking at. Now, if you have a laptop in front of you, you could look at the laptop and interact with the screen to be able to do things. But for me, having a hardware, tactile way to interact with the most important parameters is really a beneficial thing, especially if you have complex keys parts or if you have a keys player who isn't quite as confident. So one of the solutions that we've come up for here at Sunday Sounds is this color-coded decal system for the Korg Nano Control 2. We've got that in black and white. So if you use the Nano Control 2, that makes things simpler. But we also have these generic skins that are also color-coded for our Sunday Keys template. And these allow you to label any hardware that you have with really basic outlines, different colors, different text labels, to make sure that the most important parameters that you need during your live performance are really easy to understand. We've also got this auxiliary sheet that has labels for ambient pads, for the auxiliary sections of our Sunday Keys template. I'm not saying that you need to use these skins specifically, but I do highly encourage you to label the hardware that you're using. The third thing that you have to think about when it's time to set up a clean keys rig is making sure it's stable. And here I am being quite literal. You don't want your keys rig to be wobbly or easy to knock over. Try to wire things in a way where all of the weight is taken off of your connections. Make sure that you use a solid keyboard stand. And this might be a little controversial, but I firmly believe this. Please, if you can, do not use a music stand to hold your laptop. Purchase a dedicated laptop stand designed to hold the weight of a laptop securely. Some people use a TV tray and they'll actually put a little Velcro on a case on their Mac and Velcro it to the TV tray. You can set it on a rack, or you can get a second stand for your keyboard stand and set your laptop on top of that. We will put a link in the description to a laptop stand that I know is stable, that's not super expensive, and that will make sure that your laptop is sturdy. In the process of shooting this video, I went ahead and set up two example MIDI keyboard rigs that I think are nice and clean. They're not reinventing the wheel. They're just designed to be a nice, simple worship keys rig that looks clean visually. There's common gear between these two, but one is focused around using the M-Audio KeyStation 88 along with the Korg Nano Control 2. Here I am running USB from both directly into my computer via Cable Matters cables that are designed to be about the right length. And then the audio interface is sitting on the floor underneath the laptop stand. In this second example rig, we're using the Novation Launch Key 61 as the only MIDI controller. We're using some of the labels from our Sunday Keys decal sheet, so we only need this single controller to have a visual reference for everything that's going on. And so here we're running USB from the keyboard rig directly to the computer, and then we're using the Scarlett 4i4 as the audio interface. For this example rig, I chose to set the laptop immediately behind in the middle of the keyboard, just for a different look. All right, guys, so there's links in the description to all the gear we've talked about so far in this video. If you happen to buy anything through those links, we might receive a small kickback from Amazon at no extra cost to you. If you choose to make a purchase through one of those links, thank you. That's a great way to support the channel. So this video has been my subjective thoughts and ideas about setting up a clean keys rig, but I'm sure that you guys have great ideas about this too. So leave a comment and let us know your best practices or how you like to set up your keys rig so that it blends in with the stage and isn't distracting, or so that it's really easy for you to just glance at and understand during the most important parts of live performance. If you found this video helpful, go ahead and give it a thumbs up and consider sharing it with a worship leader or keys player that you know. We really appreciate your help in spreading the word about what we're doing here at Sunday Sounds.